Welcome, Bitcoin friends. It's Bitcoin Mamo. Today we're going to look at the Bitcoin charts and do some TA. We've just had the new weekly open, so we'll look at where Bitcoin's at currently. So let's get straight into the charts. So as you could see from that intro, I think this is a possibility of what might happen here. I think we might have a pullback down here, and there's a lot of confluence here with these fibs. We can see from the low down here to the top, we have the 382 level, and in bull runs we do often pull back to that 382 level and get a bounce. And doing the fib from this low to the high, this is the golden pocket area, the 0.618 level, and also from the overall retracement here from the all-time high to this low, we have that 382 level also. And I am also watching this 50-day moving average, which is coming up here quite quickly, and we are still looking for that golden cross. But I do think we are going to possibly come down and test that 50-day moving average. I do think it will hold. And also the top of that weekly EMA ribbon. I think if we touch the top of that ribbon, we will get a very strong bounce off of it. And also see we have this triangled pattern drawn here. And just taking the measured move from the second touch point and moving it to the area where we break down. We can see it also takes us down around this area where we do have these points of confluence. We also have this trend line here that connected the tops in orange here. Also was a bounce point here on this pullback. And this also lies around this area. So if I wasn't in a trade, I'd be looking to get in a trade down here. And possibly you could start layering them at around this order box, around 44.5 all the way down to 42.5, depending on your leverage. You could start lower at the bottom of this box, possibly at 43.9, 44,000. But I am in a trade still from 37,000. And I probably will add more to my trade if we do come down to this 43,000 area and bring my average buy-in up to around 40,000. Currently, we do have some hidden bullish divergence here. You can see connecting the lows on the RSI, we're getting lower lows. And on the price action, we are getting higher highs. This last one was just slightly higher, but there is that hidden bullish divergence. We have bounced off this previous one here. But again, if we do break below the bodies of the candles here and close below the bodies of this candle here, around 46.8, then that hidden bullish divergence will be negated. If we do get a pullback down to these levels I spoke about, what I also would be looking for is a bigger hidden bullish divergence here between this low and where we might bottom out here on a pullback. And I think we would probably have lower lows on the RSI and higher lows on the price. And these divergences over a longer period of time here are more relevant than the shorter ones. We are currently being supported here by the daily EMA ribbon. So we could possibly even bounce here and break the top of this triangle and move higher. But personally, I think we're getting a lot of selling pressure here. Whenever we move up, we're getting sold back down. And I think Bitcoin needs to find some more liquidity lower down before it can have a decent bounce. In last week's video, we were talking about these order blocks here on the 2 week, this bigger order block here. I did say if we close above the order block, that would be a good sign for the bulls. We were a bit higher here and we came down before the close, but we did close higher than this order block, so that is a good sign. Quite often when we do close above these order blocks, we can come back down to retest them. And if they act as support, either off the top or the bottom of the order box, and close back above the order block, then that gives me a lot of confidence that we are going to move higher. So the bottom of this order block, 45.3 approximately. Again, these are 2 week candles. I think we could have this drop down and come to these levels, but still close the 2 week inside this order block around 45.3. Same with this daily order block here. I think we can wick down, but still end the day inside this daily order block, which is at around 43.9. And just quickly, I want to give credit to this YouTube channel here. It's just called Roman. 6 months ago, I didn't know anything about order blocks, and I did learn this from him. He's a very good trader, and he provides a lot of information in his live stream videos. So I want to give credit to him. I have learned a lot from him in a short amount of time, and check out his channel because there is a lot to learn, and we all have more to learn when it comes to trading. So back to the weekly chart now, and I just want to look at the RSI here and the stochastic RSI. We can see the stochastic RSI has come up all the way to the top here, and we're starting to come down a little bit. But as I mentioned, we can stay up here for quite a long time during a bull run. And with the RSI, we did have this trend line drawn here, and we did come up to meet it, and we're currently getting pushed down by this trend line. I want to compare this mid-cycle pullback here to 2013, as we have done in previous videos. So looking at 2013 here, this was the mid-cycle pullback. The RSI was very high, pretty much at 100 reading. We had this big pullback. We bottomed out down here, and we started coming back up here. And then we did go sideways for quite a while here. We had trouble at a certain level, and then we had one quick wick down to the weekly EMA ribbon. And as we can see, the RSI did have a bit of a correction here, did go sideways for a bit. And I just want to compare that to the current cycle. So I do think, as I mentioned, we'll come back to the top of this EMA ribbon, which is around that 42,500, 43,000 area. Looking at both of these together on the RSI, what we can see here is we've had this big drop similar to 2013, and then we had this run up here similar to this one, and now we're starting to get a pullback, which we also did in the 2013 mid-cycle pullback. And I've just got this parallel channel drawn here connecting the tops and also these bottoms, and we can see it is quite similar. We did get quite close here to this line. So I think it's doing a very similar thing, and we're possibly going to spend a few weeks here going sideways with a quick wick down to that weekly EMA ribbon before completing the explosive part of this bull run. And looking at the daily chart, we have been watching this channel that we're in for quite a while. We did break below. We tried to get back into the channel. We did close inside it, but then we came back down on the new daily open, and now we're having this drop down. We are currently on top of that EMA ribbon, as we talked about, and the bottom of this daily EMA ribbon is around 43.2. So I do think we possibly come to touch the top of that weekly EMA ribbon, but still close the daily around this order block, the bottom of this order block, and inside of this daily EMA ribbon. Looking at the stochastic RSI, it has pretty much cooled off here. It is down to a 9 reading. And I just want to talk about some of the comments I've been getting. I appreciate all the feedback. If it's good or bad feedback, I appreciate criticism because I want to keep improving this channel. And one comment I got on the previous video was that I have a bullish bias. My opinion is that the bull market isn't over, and I show that more in the longer term videos and comparing that 2013 cycle. That is my opinion. It doesn't mean that I'm going to be right, but I present it based on the indicators and what I'm seeing in the chart. So I also want to present a bearish case here. And again, I don't think this is going to happen, but I do want to present both sides. This here was the start of 2020, and this was the stock market crash here that led Bitcoin to have this massive drop. And there are a lot of similarities between this channel we're in 2020 and the current channel we're in. And we can see in 2020, we came up to the 382 level, pulled back to the 618 level, carried on higher. And on this current channel, we can see we came up to the 382 level, pulled back to the 618 level, and carried on higher. And we broke down below the channel, retested it, and currently we are coming down. So it does look very similar here. And we had this pullback, we tried to recover, and then we had that stock market crash. I don't think this is going to happen unless there's another black swan event and a stock market crash. I do think we are going to come down to this 382 level, as I mentioned, around 42.5, but I do think we're going to bounce and carry higher from there. But I do want to present both sides. Interesting to note, this channel in white here, if you extend these lines and keep going to the current year, these are actually the same lines here in white. And it's interesting that both of these channels do cross here. So just something interesting that I noted with this pattern. I did just want to present that bearish case, even if it's not something that I agree with. And quickly looking at this potential golden cross here on the daily, we look at a projected date. We can see if we did stay around this 47, 48,000 area, that this golden cross would occur around September 14th. But again, I do think we're going to have that pullback to this 50-day moving average, and we can see it will get around those levels we spoke about, around 42,500, 43,000 on September 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, and 7th. So around that time frame. So it will be interesting to see how it plays out. And just quickly again, looking at the 2013 cycle here, this was the mid-cycle pullback. And just using the Fib extensions that we've talked about previously from the previous bull market top to the bear market low. This is on a logarithmic scale, and the Fib levels are based on the log scale. And you can see that's ticked here on this box if you wanted to do the same thing. And just looking at these extension levels here, we came up to that 1.618, got rejected down to 1.272. And I've just added this 1.51 line. This isn't an actual Fib number, just to compare it to the current cycle. But we can see we got stuck here at this 1.515 level for a while. And then we did pull back to the weekly EMA ribbon and also the 1.41 level before we did bounce. So just want to quickly compare that to the current cycle. And I do think they're quite similar. So again, we've got that Fib extension, previous bull market top to bear market low, and we're looking at the same levels. We had that 1.618 pullback, came back to the 1.272 level. We've come up to this 1.51 level, and we're currently getting resistance at this level. And again, the weekly EMA ribbon is around that 42.6 area, and that 1.41 level is at 41.9. So if we were to do a similar thing, come back to the top of that ribbon, also this level, and then get a bounce, then it would be very similar to that 2013 mid-cycle pullback. So just wanted to quickly show that comparison using the Fibs. And quickly on the market cipher here, we can see we've been getting a lot of mixed messages here with these green dots, red dots, green dot, red dot. This is on the 4-hour chart. As I said, if I wasn't in a trade, I would be holding off for that pullback. We can see the money flow in the red on the 4-hour. When we have a lot of mixed signals like this, then we need to look at the longer term time frames. The 6-hour has also been getting a few mixed signals here, and we have been coming down. We don't have another green dot yet on the 6-hour, and the money flow is also in the red. The 12-hour did get that green dot here, and previous times they were quite reliable on decent moves. But this one did get a red dot quite sooner, and we have come back down. The blue wave is starting to come down. It doesn't look like it's forming a green dot yet, and the daily blue wave has started coming down. We got that green dot, but again, a red dot quickly there. We didn't see a pump from it. I think the daily blue wave here does need to come below this zero line and perhaps form a tighter blue wave below, and they can be a bit more reliable on these higher term time frames. The weekly still looks good here. We don't have a red dot yet. And again, looking at that 2013 mid-cycle pullback, we did get that green dot. We had a run up. And then when we did get that red dot, that's when we had this pullback to that weekly EMA ribbon. And then we did get a green dot a couple of weeks later, and that's when the explosive part of the bull market continued to the all-time high. So you could see something similar here. We got that green dot below the zero line. We've been coming up, the blue wave starting to curve. So possibly when we see that red dot, we're going to get a pullback to that weekly EMA ribbon. And then maybe a couple of weeks later, we'll get that green dot, and then we'll see that explosive end to the bull run. So September might be a bit of sideways and a pullback, but I think October, November, December, depending on when the bull run ends, will be the explosive end to the bull run. So I think that's about all. Hopefully you enjoyed that analysis. I am still working on that indicator that I've developed. I did get some help writing the code into TradingView. So it is closer to being finished, and hopefully by next week I should have it finished, and I'll make a video on that and talk about how it works. So keep giving me your feedback. I want to constantly improve this channel, whether it's good or bad feedback. I'm happy to take criticism, and we'll have to see how Bitcoin plays out this triangle pattern if we do break lower. So thanks for watching. I'm Bitcoin Mamo. See you next time. Bye.